How's it going, everybody? This is Peter, and today we're going to be covering the Digibus MIrage, alias Optare Solo. And as you know by now, I use my middle name, but the reasons are is that I will be moving to the United States later this year to live and work, and it will be easier for me to use my middle name over there. And that's for another story though, but here we are, folks. This is the debranded Go Northeast livery, although it does have easy access. Obviously, this is an Optare Solo, but it's named and branded as the Digibus MIrage for obvious reasons. This one is the shorter wheelbase, and due to no HOF file being provided for the Yorkshire 3.0 map, we will have to just run out of service, but I will be doing the Route 8, although I cannot pick up any passengers, as I do not have the correct HOF file to set the destinations up correctly, as this add-on did not come with that HOF file, of which, considering the Yorkshire 3.0 is available from Steam and its payware, I'm a bit disappointed that it didn't come with the appropriate file, but no bother. Let's jump in the cab, folks, and let's get this bus started then. And I do know how it works this time around. Anyway, as I was trying to say there, I do know how this all works, so I will need to press neutral before I can start the bus up. And basically, I can now start the engine, but before we do anything else, I will set up the ticket machine to show you the procedure. Okay, NASA's all done. We will be following the Route 8, and just for the benefit of this add-on, and we will see how the sounds work and how the add-on will perform and stuff. And this is a shorter wheelbase with the smaller doors and all that good stuff. But very much for detail on that, it's very much the same as the last one I covered on the other channel, and that was the debranded Trent Buses one. But this is the late 1990s Mark 1 version of the Optare Solo. Okay, take two. Well, I won't fall for that trick again. I'm just going to ignore that and then take the next available right. As you know, when I went that way last time, I just fell off the track. So that's not happening again this time. So I might just do a random trip on this map, as I just want to show what the bus handles like and stuff. As you know, this add-on did not come with the Yorkshire 3 HOF file straight out of the box, and I assumed it had, having thought that this route, well, the map is available on Steam as well as this bus. So a little bit miffed as to why that wasn't the case, but no bother. And we will take the next right turn here, folks, but nonetheless, I'm just going to enjoy this short trip anyways. And what we'll do, we'll follow the route of the 76 then, just to see where we go and where we'll end up. Hopefully not in an obscure place of the map or falling through the road like we did earlier on in this let's play. So we'll just carry on and we'll just do this as a nice demo run. despite the fact that this bus does handle like a van, it is quite nice to drive actually. Very easy to handle, and being a short minibus, as that's what it really is, it does take some getting used to handling the wheels in front of you. As most of the buses I've used in this simulator, the wheels have been behind me, so I'm kind of used to those a bit more, but I will get the hang of this, folks, so just bear with me. And we're doing the route of the 75, not the 76, so I'm just going to follow the orange coloured markers, and I'm going to get past these two single decker buses, as he'll be picking up, and I'm just on a demo run here, just to show this bus in action, as I can't do a passenger run this time around. But what I will do, I will copy over one of the POF files, just so that I can use this bus on the passenger routes, unless V3D decides to include one in the future. But we're doing the route 75, so I'm following this orange marker down here, and I don't know if this is going to be a short run or a long one. I have no idea, but I do like this Yorkshire map. It's very well detailed, and I've used the load map at start, load the whole map, just to reduce lag and stuff. It doesn't lag too bad, unlike London, as that London map does lag quite a lot, unfortunately, but it's expected really, because it is a very resource intense map. And we've just reunited with the Route 8, but I'm going to stick with the Route 75 here, folks, and see that through to the end, as I'm going to treat this as a route learning experience. So just looking at the back of the bus, very much the same interior as the other one, and just jumping into the front again, as the lights have changed to green, we will be taking this next left turn and heading to where this route ends. I have no idea, but I should find the finishing point at some, well, sooner or later anyways. Okay, we're on the carriageway, so we'll see how long it takes to get up to speed. We are in a 50 miles an hour zone, although we won't get very far here because we've got a traffic queue to deal with, but we are due to go straight according to the marker up ahead, so we will be staying on the dual carriageway for a wee bit, and once this van decides to move itself, we can then proceed onwards to wherever this route ends. Okay, we're in a 40 miles an hour zone. And just say reduce speed now, so I'm assuming our turn will be coming up very soon, but we are on the dual carriageway anyway, so that's no bother. And just waiting for the next turn off point to come. I was just thinking, open the cab window, maybe we can hear the sounds a bit better, as they are a wee bit quiet in the cab on this one. But it is a Mercedes engine anyway, and the Mercedes engine isn't very big. I do think it's about possibly 100 horsepower or something. Okay, so the cons about this add-on is that there is no hot file for the Yorkshire map, so you would need to copy it over from the bailing that comes with this map if you wanted to use this bus in passenger service out of the box. But this add-on does have some good things about it. It does respond very well. It's quite flighty when you actually when it comes to negotiating turns and stuff. The only thing is, once you get used to the wheels being at the front, it is quite easy to drive. It is very much a van in terms of handling. Very much handles like a van rather than a proper bus, but it is a mini bus for a reason. And it's actually quite fun to drive, to be honest. In terms of the model anyways, I'm not sure how the real things handle like, but if I was a real bus driver, I would probably prefer something like Dennis Trident or something, such as one of the LG O2 Regs, as I do like those buses. But anyways, just got this time to go, folks. And I do prefer Dennis buses, really, such as the Dennis Trident. And I do like the Volvo V70Ls as well, but they're my favourites, along with the Enviro 400 MMCs. I do like those as well, but in terms of this add-on, this Digibus MIrage, that in the real world is an Optare Solo Mark 1, is quite interesting and fun to drive, and it's ideal for mini routes like villages and stuff, as it's easier to get round tight turns in this bus. That's where it's a bit more of a challenge with a longer bus. And thanks to that van for cutting me off, but no bother. I'm just doing my own thing here, folks, and I'm just having some fun. And I'm just trying to find out where this route will take us, as I'm going to go all the way to the end anyways. Okay, that's answered my question. I just wanted to know how fast this bus can go, and it does cling on to exactly 50 miles an hour. It cannot go any faster than that, unlike the Dennis Tridents that I have covered in previous Let's Plays and stuff. So 50 miles an hour is the maximum you're going to get out of this one, although we are in a 40 miles an hour zone. But I just wanted to see, just out of curiosity, just how fast this bus can go. And 50 is about right for this one, as per the real things. And we have to remember as well, they're not really built for power or speed or anything like that. It's just a minibus that's built for low floor, easy access for passengers. So it's just a minibus, nothing special about it really. But it is a nice addition to the UK payware add-ons, so that's definitely a good thing. And I do look forward to covering the Volvo Olympian in the future from V3D, as I do have just about all of his add-ons, both payware and freeware, and they all are very good in my opinion. And my favourites is both the Dennis Trident and the Volvo V70L, as both of those are freeware and they are the best in terms of my preference. As the only one I do have that is payware from V3D is the Optare Spectra. It's the double decker. I can't remember the name of it off the top of my head in terms of the Digibus brand, but I know the real thing is an Optare Spectra, and that's quite a good add-on. But I do prefer Dennis Tridents and Volvo V70Ls, as they are my favourites. And sticking on topic with this, we're just about coming through this road here, I'm trying to find out where the final destination will be, and I'm just looking for it. But we have got an open road here, folks, so we should be able to see just how quickly this bus can get up to 50 miles an hour. That will be the maximum this can do. Okay, folks, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to call it quits here, okay? I think we've done enough driving in this Digibus MIrage, also known as the Optare Solo in real life. This is the Mark 1 version that dates from the late 1990s. And it's more than enough to show what this bus can do. And I do like this add-on. It is a very nice pack from V3D, in my opinion. It is available to buy from Steam. And this is the first video on my main channel for it, although I did cover the Trend version on my second channel back in 2022. So if you want to check that one, you can go to my second channel to check the long wheelbase, but I just wanted to show off this short wheelbase one on my regular channel, and that'll be part of my 2023 OMSI 2 Let's Plays, and there will be plenty more to come this year of different buses and stuff. So I'm looking forward to covering the Volvo Olympian in due course, as and when that is out. But likewise, folks, I just want to say to you, if you stayed with me through to the end of this Let's Play, big thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one. All the best, God bless, and I'll see you later.